行くぜ、ぶっ飛ばしてやれ。
Yōgen no Naota was a one-shot published in Shonen Jump SQ, or Jump Squared, in August of 2015. Naota is an antichrist, the harbinger of the end, and the horned little sister of Kenji, a respectable teenager trying to make ends meet despite the magic world they live in rejecting his sister's existence outright. Kenji is a level-headed but protective older brother who's just trying to coexist. Despite Naota's destructive capabilities and strange speech patterns, Kenji desperately tries to understand and love his younger sister, promising to protect her and make sure the fabled apocalypse never happens. It's a heartfelt tale despite how short it is, emphasizing the familial ties these two have and how harsh the world around them truly is. This one-shot was so popular amongst the author's work that it even got an official manga dub on Shonen Jump's YouTube channel, reaching over 300,000 views and 11,000 likes. This one-shot, despite its length and seemingly being more of a pilot chapter than a simple one-off, is the perfect example of the storytelling methods employed by its rising star author in the world of manga, Tatsuki Fujimoto. Fujimoto, age 27 from the Akita Prefecture, was heavily influenced by the works of Hiroaki Samura and Nihei Suotomu, the mangakas of Blade of the Immortal and Abara, respectively. An oil painting major from the Tohoku University of Art and Design, Fujimoto's passion for reading and creating manga originated in his childhood, creating a fictitious production house in his head, and visibly crying at times when their stories ended. These various daydream manga ideas would be integrated into his published work, in Jump. The results being interesting, to say the least. As a personality, Fujimoto is an anxious eccentric with a somewhat curt way of speaking. His official Twitter is a fictitious personality he created, a fake little sister named Koharu, who tweets out short day-to-day moments, odd phrases, and shoutouts for fellow mangaka. Fans of Fujimoto enjoy playing along with this, including his colleagues, such as One and Yusuke Murata, the team behind One Punch Man. Fujimoto, despite all odds, is seemingly content and in awe of the success he's achieved, especially when read by his idols. A hard worker even before the release of his first ongoing Fire Punch on the online publication Jump Plus, he would send his editor one pitch a day at his peak. Although his ideas were half-baked most of the time, it showed his dedication to the craft and creating manga. A masochistic man hungry for work, Fujimoto learned to refine his art and integrate ideas from film and other comics into his own. A piece of advice he gives every mangaka is simple, and is shown heavily throughout his pages. Sign up for Netflix. As a creator, being a student of the world is important. Taking in concepts from your surroundings and interpreting them differently is part of the game. Fujimoto learned this, studied films he enjoyed such as the Korean thriller The Chaser, and hit the ground running with his debut at age 23. This eccentricity with an honest, emotional core is shown in all of his work, even in his first release.
Hey, come on, come on!
Released in December of 2011, Niwa Niwa, Niwa Niwa Tori Ga Ita is a one-shot about an alien-inhabited Earth and the humans struggling to survive in disguise. It is a comedy manga with occasional dynamic posing and a clear but not well-executed moral. As a one-shot, it's not the strongest piece of work, but maintains the same emotional core that's carried throughout all Fujimoto's work. The use of body horror and dark humor also dates to here, as Fujimoto continues these themes throughout most of his bibliography and strengthens his art style over time. Sadly, some of his work is considered lost media, as there are no scans or English translations for 2013 works Seigi no Mikata and Kami Hikoki. But a Shueisha Jury Award winner, Sasaki-kun ga Judan Tomita, does. More on par with his later work, Sasaki-kun's moral is about doing the impossible despite the perception of it being, well, impossible. Despite its strange love story angle, it's a strong one-shot that's handled with care, showing off the strengths of its human character designs, as well as a simple-to-understand moral, executed in a surreal but satisfying way. Koewa Momoku, released in 2013's Jump SQ 19, follows in the tradition of Fujimoto's non-traditional love story, portraying the coming of the end of the world being saved by a senpai's confession to his kohai and the power of love in a more literal way than most. This work is on par with Sasaki-kun ga Judan Tomita, being a competent story with an interesting delivery. Not to mention, Fujimoto's creature designs and standard style of human drawing starts coming into form here. From this point on, Fujimoto's facial expressions become much more exaggerated and, well, expressive, continuing into his ongoing work. Another note is Fujimoto's use of paneling and how the eye is drawn from one panel to another in a quick, breezy way. This is important for manga, as it's meant to be read in a flash or in between lunch breaks. These being one-shots make it all the more important that a story is conveyed in an easy-to-understand and striking way, especially when art is pushed outside of the usual paneling. This love story dynamic is continued into 2014's Shihaku, the tale of an assassin whose only emotion is happiness, and the vampire who hires her to kill him. Fujimoto's character work over time has become more distinct, designs much more recognizable as his own rather than a generically simple high schooler. Not to call his previous designs weak, but there is a noticeable change in artistic ability and character identity post-2013 than prior. Me wo sametara onna no ko ni naritai yo, or When I Woke Up, I Had Become a Girl Disease, is the last of these love story one-shots, and certainly the most interesting from a glance. A strangely positive tale about love despite any sudden change life may bring, it contains the typical sexual wackiness you'd expect from Fujimoto characters, with a moral whose heart beats throughout the pages like Sasaki-kun or Koi wa Momoku. This is a good time to mention Fujimoto's humor, as it's a major element in most of his work. Fujimoto is clearly a fan of dark comedy due to his love of horror, as well as very gross-out centric or raunchy jokes. These are not bad things, rather at times they do add to his stories in a rather unique way, but these are mainly preferential, and not all readers will enjoy them. A final one-shot up for discussion is 2017's Imoto no Ane, a one-shot published in Jump SQ that's about the relationship between two art school sisters and the nude oil paintings the younger sister drew of her older sister. Needless to say, this is an odd tale. It's the type of story Fujimoto's comfortable telling, and his experiences in art school are clearly portrayed in some of these panels. There are some uncomfortable moments, but things are never pushed to a gratuitous or perverted degree. It's kept surprisingly tasteful, despite the clearly sexual undercurrent. This is Fujimoto's character designs at their clearest for a one-shot. His expressions are on point, as well as his use of gesture. It flows very well, and the detailing even in background shots do work to his advantage. Knowing by this point he would have an assistant of some sort like he did with 2016's Fire Punch, it's no surprise that this work is much more clean than his debut. Speaking of which...
Bring it on! I'll destroy you all!
Fire Punch was a Jump Plus manga that spanned 8 volumes and 83 chapters. Jump Plus, a digital-only service through Shonen Jump, allowed for a lot of variety that the main weekly Shonen Jump wasn't skewed toward. As a result, much more creative freedom is given to Fujimoto, and that freedom flies onto the page. A post-apocalyptic tale with a main character partially inspired by 1970s snack icon, Anpan Man. Fire Punch is a story that defies the typical expectations of shonen manga. The main character Agni starts as a typical revenge seeker, before falling deeper and deeper into a rabbit hole where the audience can only guess where it goes. Themes of religion, identity, and the power of love breaking hate. Fire Punch is a surprisingly emotional story that has a plethora of excellent moments and notable paneling. Like mentioned before, Fujimoto's paneling for Fire Punch is easy to read and understand what's happening, while maintaining his own style and elevating his storytelling abilities. Told that he would only have up to 3 volumes by his editor upon serialization, Fujimoto's ability to throw the audience for a loop due to subversion is ramped up. Things take turns you wouldn't necessarily expect when you first read. Time moves differently at points, and people just suddenly drop dead. It still maintains a level of not only craftsmanship, but personality that not many modern manga tend to have. It has its weak spots, and its ending, although satisfying to a degree, is a bit rushed. Yet, it's definitely deserved the popularity it received in a gratifying read from cover to cover. Chainsaw Man is a 2018 manga published in Weekly Shonen Jump with a total of 11 volumes across 97 chapters. Chainsaw Man is the story of Denji and his ability to turn into the anti-hero Chainsaw Man after being brought back from death. He's recruited into the Public Safety Bureau by the elusive and highly sought-after Makima, given a home and purpose, something he's never truly had. Chainsaw Man, like its predecessor Fire Punch, is a subversive and at times heartbreaking work about life, death, love, and the nature of heroism. This is truly when Fujimoto's human characters as well as his monster designs really shine. While Fire Punch had a plethora of great design work, it suffered from a lack of detail in some moments and other things. Chainsaw Man feels different enough from Fire Punch in terms of setting, but the core design work that helped elevate Fire Punch remains consistent and solid. Although technically unfinished as of this writing, Chainsaw Man's public safety arc remains a popular work that's only rising due to an anime announcement. From its loud, raunchy, and disgusting humor to its tender and bittersweet moments where things slow to a crawl, Chainsaw Man is a standout in Fujimoto's lineup for a very good reason. It even won the Shokugakugan Manga Award for 2021, solidifying its place in the manga sphere for at least another year. And look, there's Naluta, back from the grave of the one-shot she originated from, promising to end the world in some capacity, and reincorporated into Fujimoto's next major narrative. In conclusion, Tatsuki Fujimoto is a mangaka who specializes in the surface-level absurd while integrating heartfelt moments between odd but likable characters. Someone who specializes in subversion and shock, Fujimoto continues to be a creator to look out for, and someone not to underestimate. Thank you for watching.